Time to talk about math language again. If you've ever studied a foreign language, you will have experienced that when you try to say or process numbers, like giving your phone number or asking for a price, it takes a little longer to process. This is because your brain has two jobs when you hear or say numbers in another language. First, it has to remember the sound of the number in that language. That's your brain's audio notepad, called the phonological loop. Then, it has to connect the sound to the actual quantity. And that part lives in a different brain area, the parietal lobe, which handles math and amounts. When it's your first language, the path is short and direct. When it's your second or third, your brain sometimes takes a detour through your main language first, just to double check. That detour is what makes it a little slower. So number words are not universal, and they change how students learn math. In French, we like to map a little before we math by giving you a mental load in the number word.
70, 80, 99.
And that's why French kids are so good at arithmetic.
There is specific arithmetic?
Oh, the French are actually below average.
In most Asian languages, we have a beautiful logic.
Unlike French.
They follow this nice structure.
11, 23, 74.
This makes everything clean and easy to follow. English is easy, right?
11, 12.
Then suddenly, we remember how to count again.
13, 14.
What happened? Who's in charge here? In German and Arabic, we say the ones place first.
35.
Hey, don't panic. I know it's long, it's just agglutination. Also logical, with a twist.
35.
Anyway, when number words follow math logic, kids can hear the structure, like place value and operations.
But when they don't?
That's extra cognitive load for students learning math in their second or third language. So, the next time a student pauses when saying a number, it's possible they're not just trying to say the number. They could be trying to remember the structure. Numbers are hard. Follow me for more. And translanguaging tips.